Hey there, music teachers and students. I'm Zlata and I've been teaching the violin online for over 10 years. And I'd like to share three ways to teach online from my experience. It's easier and faster to take your studio online these days. And perhaps you're forced to do so right now, or maybe you want to do so anyway. And the first is the most easy way, and that is to teach via Skype or Zoom. That's an alternative, maybe via FaceTime. The advantages are that it's not so different from teaching offline live lessons. You can even maintain your schedule. You can teach your current students in that way. And the software to use, like Zoom or Skype, is very easy to use. You can use any device. You can use your smartphone if you have some kind of holder for it. You can use your laptop. What's important is that the light is coming at you. So if you have a window, you want to look at the window like I'm looking right now and not have the window behind you. If there's no other way, then you can close the curtain perhaps. It's handy to have a digital sheet music library. Maybe you can use a split screen that you can see your student and see the sheet music. And you can just ask your students to email you their sheet music in PDF. In that way, you don't have to do the work and you have all the notes and fingerings that you made for them. An instrument stand is something that's very handy because you're probably juggling behind your computer with sheet music and your instruments. You can use a regular music stand or a tabletop stand. You can even use a cookbook stand for your sheet music. Just see what is handy for you. If you have new students coming in, maybe international students, then you could use a tool like Calendly. And they can schedule it in their time zone and you'll automatically get it in your time zone. And Calendly can also handle the payments for you, so that can be very handy. You can also join a platform like Play With A Pro, who handle everything for you, even the lesson itself, so you don't even need Skype. They do all the payments, scheduling and video. But there are other ways to teach online as well. You can do video exchange, and don't overthink this. You can just make a video with your phone and publish it on YouTube as unlisted, send it to your student, or the other way around. Your student can ask you for feedback. You can give the feedback in a video or just by email, depending on what you need. You can even use WhatsApp for that. So it saves you the hassle of maybe a bad connection. Can you hear me? Oh, the connection is bad, blah, 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 blah. It's flexible. You can do it whenever the student needs it. The student can, for example, pay per video exchange or whatever. You don't have to sit through lessons when the student didn't practice and you don't really know what to do. So video exchange is, I think, a better way than this live one-on-one Skype thing. And you're also not dependent on time zone, for example. So if you're working with international students, like I do a lot, then video exchange is very handy. You can also develop an online course. If you make a short one, it can be relatively quickly. But for example, I've made an extensive course on bow technique that really took me years to develop and thousands of dollars. But you can do something very easy or anything in between. You can even just make unlisted videos, like with Video Exchange, and then just send links to your students. Or you can use a protected page on your website, for example. That's really easy to do in WordPress. You can also join a platform like becoming an iClassical mentor. They set up the whole course for you. You just have to make the videos. The same for Teachable. Everything is inside there, publishing your course. Although Teachable is a paid tool, it's not very expensive. If you're starting out and you want to do it yourself, that's very easy if you have a WordPress site and you combine it with OptimizePress and Wishlist Member. Really easy to do, and the software is not that expensive. If you want a very extensive course with a lot of features like I have, then you have some time and money to spend, but this is not a short-term thingy, then you can get a WordPress site, perhaps with a DV theme, and use Access Ally for the protection of your course. So there are three possibilities. You can do live online lessons, you can do video exchange, which is also one-on-one, it's just not live. And then you can make an online course that you can sell to students. Of course, you can do any combination in this. You can teach live combined with a video curriculum that you already have, or you can teach live and then in between, when the student gets lost, do some video exchange. You can get really creative. And in my experience, this combination of different ways of learning, so that you have the set curriculum that they follow, but you also have this personal guidance, I think that works best in terms of online lessons. So I hope I took some worry out of your head. Know that it is easier than you think. Start very simple, maybe just with Skype lessons with your current students, and please don't let people convince you that you need some kind of very expensive business building course. You really don't need that. That's just what I wanted to share today. And stay safe, stay healthy, and see you in another video. Bye bye.